Hello, good afternoon. Welcome to the March 26th Money Mondays with the City of Stillwater. My name is Megan Kasak. I'm the Communications Coordinator, and we're here with Chief Financial Officer Melissa Reames. Thank you for joining us again.
Thank you for having me, Megan.
Absolutely. So today, you want to talk a little bit more about the budget process.
Right.
And what that all encompasses and what to expect in the coming weeks and everything that goes into planning a city budget.
That's right. This process is really not any different than we conduct in our own personal lives. We're trying to marry up our revenues coming in or our sources of money coming in against our uses of money or expenditures going out. And sometimes we know in our own personal lives there's more month than there is money, isn't there?
Mm-hmm.
And so we have to look at how do we juggle and how do we make all the puzzle pieces fit together. The city has adopted the state's Municipal Budget Act, and so there are certain constraints there about timing of the budget and when we have to adopt the budget. So under the Municipal Budget Act, I believe we have to get a budget adopted 15 days prior to the beginning of our fiscal year. So you can see we're still in plenty good time to get that done and get it loaded into our system. That would put us about the middle of June. So we're still way ahead of the game, which is where I like to be when we're doing budget. And so I want to give our viewers a few just basic definitions to start with. I think that always helps to set the ground rules and the framework. A budget is simply an estimation of revenues and expenses or sources and uses and projecting into the future. So you're trying to use your crystal ball, if you will, and look into the future and see how you can make your source of income marry up with your use of income or use of money. Okay? So budget. A balanced budget simply means that your expenditures are going to equal your revenue. You're going to come out zero at the bottom. If you come out negative, you have to find another source of revenue, don't you? Because you had more expenditures than you had revenue. We talk about restricted fund balance and we talk about designated funds. Restricted funds mean that we have entered into an agreement that will restrict the use of that money. I'm trying to think of an example of a restricted fund. A good one would be the half penny sales tax. That money is earmarked for specific use, and we put it in a fund all of its own, and that is the only use that it can be used for, because our citizens came in and said we will approve this if this is what you use it for. So restricted. Designated is a little looser. It's still earmarked for a purpose, but it's not like it was through the vote of the people. It may be that it is through the designation by council of how we're going to use those funds. So a little bit looser designation or looser restriction on the money. And then you get down to undesignated. The 2 cents sales tax is what I call undesignated revenue. It can come in and be used for however we need to use it within the general fund. We can move it around to the airport, to different places that it needs to go. There was a really good chart in yesterday's news press, and it was looking at sales tax collections over the last 10 years. And if you saw that chart, you would see it increasing up to about the year 2014, fiscal year now, 2014, and then you can see it start to decline, and it's kind of plateaued. And so as we were looking at revenue for the next year, we were looking at those trends to decide what did we think sales tax was going to do in the next year. And we concluded that we are going to keep sales tax level. We're not going to go up, we're not going to go down, we're going to leave it at $28.4 million for the next year. We're tracking it. If we see that we start to take a big nosedive, we may come in and do a budget amendment and come move that money down. So sales tax is one of our primary sources of revenue. Use tax is another source. Remember, we've talked talked a lot about sales and use tax over the last year, year and a half. Use tax is a companion piece to sales tax. Now, interestingly, as sales tax is kind of dropping and tailoring off or leveling off, use tax continues to rise. And so do we count on that to continue? You know, do we say, oh, we're more comfortable down here at a lower level because we think that it's volatile and it may level off? I've gone ahead and moved it up to $1.6 million. That's what's in the proposed budget right now. Last year's budget was just shy of $1.1 million. So I'm going to bank on the fact that it's going to stay and continue to increase. If we see it start to drop off, we will come back with a budget amendment because we can't spend what's not coming in. Some of the other sources of revenue, we get apportioned cigarette and tobacco tax. We get gasoline taxes, some 911 fees. We also get a little bit of property tax that goes to the sinking fund to pay the debt that the voters approved back in the year 2000. And you and I have been talking over the last few months about a new general obligation bond. That's what the sinking fund takes care of. So revenue assumptions, again, sales tax is going to stay the same, 28.4. We've increased use tax to 1.6. The other funds, the other sources of revenue, I've looked at how they've come in this year, and in some cases I've moved them down. We've seen cigarette and tobacco take a drop, which is a good thing. That was the whole point behind TSET, was to get people to cut back on their usage of cigarette and tobacco products. And the utility revenue, which affects the transfer coming in, we have taken a very conservative approach. So it may be that the transfer is lower than what it's been in the past because we've taken that conservative approach with our SUA budget. The expenditure assumptions, again, I can't praise our staff enough. You have a lot of really conscientious people that work here at the city, and they've done their very, very best to trim their budgets and make sure that what we budget is what they actually need for the next year. There are some wants, and we take those on a case-by-case basis, but we're really trying to get that budget pared back to where it is what it takes to operate the city, and that there's not a lot of padding in that budget that gets us off track. So we've benchmarked our departmental expenditures off of a three-year average of actual expenditures in 15, 16, and 17. We have looked at our service level agreements and tried to shift not as much of the services as we can, because we're trying to get a quality product for our citizens. But where it makes sense, we've entered into service level agreements with other entities that can provide the services that citizens want and need at a better cost, at a better price point. We do have some capital in this year's budget. If you remember, last year we had no capital. This year we do. We need a complete refresh on our computer system. They are, I think they're at the five-year mark, which is getting kind of aged, mm-hmm. old, thank you, and looking at some new cruisers for our police department, and they need a few other things there. So that's primarily where we focused. Utility expenditures, again, developed using a very conservative approach. And personnel costs. We have really looked at our personnel costs, trying to make sure that the people that we have are in the right positions and that we're using not only our financial resources well, but our personnel resources well as also. So that's kind of the budget that's been developed. This evening, we're going to have a study session with the council mm-hmm. to to kind of apprise them of where we are, how things are looking, and how we've developed what we will be presenting in a public hearing to our citizens. And the timeline, if you can't come and join us this evening, we're going to have the study session. It will be videotaped, I believe,
yes,
and replayed on channel 14.
Yes, Suddenlink channel 14 and AT&T U-verse channel 99. And then we also have a web stream link at stillwater.org where you can watch the meetings live on those channels and on the web stream. And then we will replay City Council twice every day following that.
Okay. The next up that you will start seeing is we're going to have a public hearing on April the 16th. And again, this is your opportunity as the public to come and express concerns, suggestions on something that is scheduled for discussion with the council. We will be publishing in the paper. You and I just talked about that. I believe it's going to be April the 15th and then April the 8th. So the two Sundays before we have the public hearing. Again, it's a big high level overview of the budget, and I do believe at times it can be it gets the point across, but it's not as transparent as I would like to have it be, and we're going to be working on that for the public. So on the 16th, public hearing. Then we bring it back on May the 7th because we have to, by resolution, adopt the budget. And so that's when we were asking the council and the trustees, because we'll bring the SUA and the CETA budget as well. We're asking them to adopt that budget on May the 7th. And then that gives the finance staff a good 6 weeks to get that budget loaded into the system, to work on any adjustments that need to be made for carry forwards. We can talk about carry forwards another day because it's mm-hmm. a subject in and of itself. And then we will be ready to go business as usual July 1st when we start our fiscal 19 budget.
All right, so we're really gearing into getting close mm-hmm. to that final budget.
We are.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, I think we've covered it pretty well. Again, just be watching for, there's so many avenues for you to be involved in your city government that doesn't necessitate you coming up here to City Hall. Mm-hmm. And so I hope that either through Facebook or the video pods that we do or the videotape of the council meetings, that our citizens stay involved with what's going on here at the city.
Absolutely. Other great ways that you can stay involved on topics like this, we do put out a monthly sales tax report that Melissa helps mm-hmm. to provide that information so that we can tell you how our sales tax collection, those use tax and tobacco and cigarette tax collections are going every month and what that means for our city. If you go to stillwater.org, our news page, you can actually follow and track those news stories through our e-notifications system. Just click general government and you can get email notifications each time an update is added to our website. We have a web page specifically dedicated to all things budget, stillwater.org/budget, and you can learn more about this process and what you can do to be a part of the process. If you want to learn more about some of those GO bond projects that we've talked about today, stillwater.org/GO bond. We're happy to answer any questions, so please, if in the comment section or put what questions maybe that you thought of, and we'll share them with Melissa or our staff mm-hmm. to see if we can get you an answer. But thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you, Melissa.
Thank you, Megan.
And we look forward to hearing your questions and feedback and possibly seeing you on April 16th for that public hearing.